Welcome to the Wally Show Precast. We are Facebook Live-ing this as well, so if you want to follow along with our beautiful mugs, you can do so as I wipe my nose. That was weird. All right, so that's all the goodness of the Precast. We have Rebe with us today, too, because we're going to do something fun here at the end. She's from our blog report. We are gonna, and you get to see her. Like, I don't know if a lot of people see you. You end up being more behind the scenes.
Depends.
And
you're having a great hair day.
Thank you.
Oh, fantastic.
I just had a feeling. Because Zach said he wanted to show me this new camera, and I was like, I'm probably going to end up on it.
Yeah, and so you did it up today.
Yep.
That's good.
And then there are some of us who are on it every day, and I'm, like, trying to adjust myself so I look like...
And you have requested that we can... You have, like, a certain number of skips allowed that...
Yes.
Right, yes.
No,
vetoes.
No Facebook Live today.
I get a weekly veto.
Yeah.
And I definitely... When I am overdue on dyeing my roots, I get automatic veto rights.
Yeah, because where the camera is, it's up kind of above, and so it looks right down onto Becca's scalp because she sits closest to it.
And we all know this is a fake hair color.
Yeah, so enjoy that now. You can follow along. This is the stuff that we didn't get to during the show. A couple questions. These actually came in not as part of birthday requests. People just asking some questions, so that's fine. Here's some for everyone on the show. Wally, if you could give up one unhealthy snack for the rest of your life, what would it be? Oh, none of them. They're all my children. I don't know if I had to give up one, I think it would be gummy bears. Like, I love gummy bears more than I love my children. But I think that that's the one I'd give up. Like, I couldn't give up chips. I definitely couldn't give up cookies. So gummy bears would have to be it.
Can we play the German gummy bear song in celebration?
Oh, I remember that. Yes. Can you find that real quick?
All right.
We'll go to... Oh, you got it.
Yes.
Wow, that's pretty fast there, Zach. Here we go.
Leben im Wald unter Bäumen und Steinen, in ihren Höhlen, da sind sie zu Haus. Gummibären, hüpfen hier und dort und überall. Sie sind für dich da, wenn du sie brauchst. Das sind die Gummibären.
Da gummy bears.
Yes.
Boy, I'm hungry for gummy bears now.
You just gave them up for life.
This backfired. Becca, what celebrity are you currently a fangirl of?
Yeah, oh, Tori Kelly.
Still?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness. She is the love of
Taya
my...
Smith just commented how...
Whoa.
Oh.
What happened to Joey?
No,
not what I meant. She is the... Light of nope.
Nope.
She's the wind beneath your wings.
Yes, she's the wind beneath my wings.
What do you like so much about Tori Kelly?
I mean, love her music,
okay.
Genuinely. B, I
Does
think.
Does it speak to your soul?
Yes.
Okay.
I think that she's a great role model. She has not had that big scandalous thing. Like, and you can hear in her songs that her faith is woven through her music, even as a mainstream artist, and other themes that I think are just really good messages.
You know what's a bummer is your other fangirl that you used to fangirl over is Taylor Swift.
I'm over
she
her.
She had held out for so long and kept a good, clean image, and had really done a decent job managing that despite her serial dating and stuff. She kept a lot of the personal details out of the media and stuff. And I thought she did a good job, and I thought she was, you know, a generous person and things. And then she did a video for that 50 Shades grayer or darker, I don't even know, movie. And it's like, and she's dressed all like in lingerie, I guess. I'm not saying this just to like try to look like a righteous man. I haven't seen it.
Right, but they've shown clips on the news. But
I haven't even seen those.
But it's happened before that. She was just going down a path that, like, I still enjoy her music, but there are a lot of things that I just can't connect with anymore. And another thing for me to be a fan, whenever I fangirl over someone, it's really because I want to be their very best friend.
Right.
And I feel like Taylor
Squad
and I
goals.
Have drifted apart.
Right.
and we're not in the same place in life anymore.
You could be in Tori Kelly's squad, but not Taylor's
That's
anymore.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
I think Tori Kelly, if you're listening, because of course you listen to the Wally Show podcast, because who doesn't? Call me. We should hang out sometime.
Do we know where Tori lives? Is she an L.A. girl?
She's in,
I
yeah,
think so.
Cali.
Oh, nuts. Okay.
So are you saying you and Taysway are never, ever, ever, ever getting back together again?
Correct. Well, three evers, but that's
That just tells me there's a chance.
That was a test.
Yeah, that tells me that she's still leaving that door open.
What
All
about
right.
Taya Smith?
Taya Smith, I love.
She's hurt by your comments.
I think I ruined it, though, by being too awkward around her. So I
you
feel
smell good.
Like,
yes.
That was awkward.
Like,
I feel like with Tori Kelly, well, everyone has a T name. Taylor, Taya, and Tori.
Wow.
I feel like with Tori, I haven't ruined it yet. And so if I ever were to meet her, I'd be like, oh, hey, it's cool. Yeah, we're just hanging out, whatever. And then she'd be like, oh my gosh, we're best friends. I'd be like, yeah, we are.
Yeah, yes.
That's how I see that going.
No, I don't see it going like that at all. I see it going like the Taya thing where you meet her and your first thing is, you smell good. Like,
I've learned my lesson, okay?
Okay, that was weird.
There's just like, some really...
I've made my career out of doing weird things. And, like, I totally get, like, walking up to somebody and doing something that's really odd in front of them, and it makes them remember you. But you have to realize that sometimes it goes the opposite way. And telling someone that you just met for the first time in a professional setting that they smell good, I don't know. That one, I think, is weird.
Okay, hear me out. What if she actually did smell good?
Doesn't
matter.
And yeah, it's still not a thing.
Well,
honestly,
girls can get it away with it a little better than guys.
Keep telling yourself that. And when was Taya last here? Oh, that's right. Never since that day.
I just like to compliment people. I told Betty today she looks like an American girl.
Yes, she's having a cute little ponytail or a pigtail day in a hat.
Yeah, thank you.
So that's good.
Thank you. See, that's not weird.
No, that's not weird. But if you had said your hair smells good,
I would say that too.
Let me see. Betty, you like older things. So does my wife. So what is your guilty pleasure of something that you like but you know you're too young for? So you like older things, but what is something that you like that you're like, yeah, I'm still too young for that, but I like it?
Well, I just finished the Dick Van Dyke Show. I watched all seasons.
That's so funny.
I was contemplating buying all the Three's Company seasons. I did not.
I was not
that.
Allowed to watch Three's Company as a kid.
I just love John Ritter.
Yeah.
He's just the cutest thing.
I think that whole concept of they were all living in a house together as roommates and it was two girls and a guy.
Yeah.
Like for my family.
Iffy.
Yeah, at that time, even though there was nothing going on with them, it was like, nope, you can't. Like that was off the table.
I'm considering, I want to learn how to, I forget what it's called now, but there's a
macrame.
Macrame. I want to learn how to
we
macrame.
We finish each other's
sandwiches. But I used to knit. I stopped doing that. I want to get another cat. There's a lot of sad things in my life. I don't know.
Yeah, you're an old soul, though.
Yeah.
Even your luggage is like an old soul. It's like you've got like hipster luggage and it's...
I'm not hipster. I am...
It became hipster. Other people want to be hipster like you.
I'm the one that's setting the hipster
trends.
Did
we find the original hipster?
Well, I think we might have.
I just realized, because the question was something that maybe is too young for you're embarrassed about. I think I know what it is for you.
What?
And it's a TV show that you watch. Pretty Little Liars.
Oh.
It's your guilty pleasure.
Pretty Little Liars. It's terrible.
Pretty Little Liars?
Oh, did you?
Once they found out who the girl was, I was like, okay, done.
Yeah.
There's too much drama.
It's like a soap opera.
It's
so
unrealistic. It's like those teenage girls cannot have that much drama in their life.
No, I'm out on that one. Zach, nope, no question for Zach.
Okay.
What's the question?
It wasn't a question. It was not. There was no question.
Was it like you were the supreme ruler of all or something like that?
Nope. Just, Zach, what's your favorite picture or video of Anna right now?
Oh, my word.
See, you guys made
it. Here comes the longest precast ever.
Oh, my word. You could show it to the camera if you want.
No, I don't have one ever.
Yeah. Oh, really? Let me see if I can look through my phone and oh, there's one.
And the sad thing is, Zach's on Instagram now, and genuinely, I like seeing pictures of Anna on Instagram and stuff, but then the next morning, he comes in and shows the exact same videos.
Oh, yeah.
Except the full version.
In case you missed
it. The director's
cut.
Yes,
you need the director's
cut. Like, I don't need this.
And you're welcome.
That's funny.
I can't even pick. No.
There's
you can't
too many
even?
Cute ones.
No.
All right.
I'm sorry.
Wow, that's... Boy, I don't know how that guy did that. How in the world did Howard get, or Joseph get you to not show us a picture?
I mean,
I guess just the secret is just asking for them.
Well, asking for one.
Oh, that's right, because, like, that kind of stuff paralyzes
yeah,
you.
Yeah, like, if you're, yeah,
what's
show
your
me your
favorite
one favorite
Anna picture. Yeah, you can't do
here,
it.
Here, I'll show, here's her at her 2-year birthday party.
Describe it, too, because we're still doing a podcast here. I know you're showing it. Tell Becca.
It's her blowing out her birthday candle.
Oh.
That's adorable.
That's cute.
It's her filling out her birthday candles. It's adorable is what he said.
Okay.
It is really cute.
Let's see. Melly says she has spent time overseas. What's the most awkward comment you've ever received on an overseas trip about the fact that you're white? I've never received a comment, but in Africa, we were in places in Africa that they had never seen anybody of a different color. We were so far out. and it was crazy to watch them rub your skin and try to take the color off of your skin. It's kind of cool. And just a reminder too of like, wow, we think that everything is about us and our world, and there are people that don't even know that like we exist. And it was kind of a cool moment. I thought that was neat.
And everywhere you go, they shout, Mzungu!
Mzungu! Mzungu! Yeah, that's the best. Meets white person. So when places where they've seen white people, it's great. There's this one kid, I remember we were in Africa, and this kid is walking along, and I'm walking, coming out of this hallway thing, and he's like, he's singing, like, ha na 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 na, Mzungu! Ha na na na. Like, it's just like totally ingrained, and it just, they shout it out and then just keep going.
It's like slug bug to slug back.
Yeah.
Right. Ow! I'm sorry, I forgot you were sore. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Everybody poking and hitting me.
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, Betty Rock is still sore from yesterday's workout.
2 days ago.
2 days ago. It's two worse. Days now? Oh my
yeah.
God.
Yeah,
it gets oh,
worse.
Wow.
It's so day. Bad. Every time I turned over in my sleep last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, Becca's not having a good run of it either. This is something that was interesting. Sarah sent me this and said, I thought you guys might like to know about this. VidAngel is an internet streaming company that lets you filter out movies that you rent, like for sex, language, violence, and things like that. But 20th Century Fox, Warner Brothers, and Lucasfilms are suing and shutting down VidAngel. And she had given me some links and stuff and a petition to sign. And I went and looked at it. And I watched the video. And Zach, you've seen this too, right?
Yes.
I was kind of surprised at how well they shot a video. Like, they weren't, like, angry, like, oh, and they're trying to squash us and they're evil people and stuff. Like, they did the video so well that it gave it credibility. That
yeah,
you're like,
and
oh.
It was funny, but really thorough.
And informative. Yeah. And they covered, like, really difficult information about the laws and why. But I didn't even know that thing was an option, you know, to rent a video from them that you could filter.
There's been various forms of filtering like that, but it always gets shut down by Hollywood because they start using the word censorship,
right,
or taking away the director's creative freedom, and they claim that once that director has made that work, no one's allowed to edit it.
That's a tough thing, like, because you're not editing the Mona Lisa. It's not like there's an art piece and you're going in and everyone's adding to it or taking away from it.
And not an original.
Right. Like, it's a copy.
Right.
And there's some things that you'd think, okay, that's something I want to watch as a family. It's right. It's a family film. Like The Sandlot, for example. You'd think family film, right?
Right.
We watched that when I was a youth counselor one year at a camp, and there was a deaf child, and so we had to have the subtitles on. There is more language in The Sandlot than you would expect.
Right.
And some other themes that you're like, ooh, so we had to shut the movie down. Like, it was uncomfortable for these young kids. And so something like that where you're like, this is something I grew up watching and I never noticed those things, but I don't know if I'd feel comfortable showing it to my kids at a young age.
Oh, that happens with movies all the time. Like, I remember things holistically. Like, I remember the feeling that it gave me. So I'll remember a movie and go, oh, that was a great movie.
Right, yeah.
But then when you go back into it, there's like three parts in it that you're like, oh, wow, I would not let my kid watch that. But that's not the part I was thinking about, you know? But I think that happens. So the ability to, in your own home, and you're not rebroadcasting this, decide what you can skip it if you want to.
Right.
With
yeah.
Your
am I not allowed to go to the bathroom during a scene I don't want to see?
Right.
Is that infringing on your right, almighty director?
Yeah, that's what I don't get. And hey, dude, I rented your movie. Shut up. You got paid.
Right.
What do you
right.
care?
Right. They're putting their agenda and values ahead of even their money, which is
weird.
Bizarre.
Yeah.
Like, if you look just financially, G-PG movies make far more money than PG-13. PG-13 movies make far more than R. You
right.
know? So if you opened up the movies to a broader audience, you would make far more money.
Like, I get if somebody was, like, taking the movie and showing it in public and charging for it and altering
sure.
it. Like,
sure.
I get that.
Yeah.
Because then you're putting up this work and you're altering it for consumption by people.
And
but
if the edits make it a bad movie, like, it takes out critical plot lines,
right.
people walk away from the movie saying that movie was horrible.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I get that. I've heard really good things about VidAngel, but if it were to get shunned down, it'd be a sad day. But you could always use the Becca family tool. What they would do is say, hey, Becca, I think I need another Diet Pepsi. Could you go up and get me one? And just stay up there a few minutes.
Yeah.
But, Dad, you already have. Just go get one.
Get me
just
four more.
Go get another one.
Yeah.
Walk around the house a little bit.
They used to have a thing that you worked with VCRs even back in the day where you'd punch in the code for the movie.
I do
and
remember
it would
that.
Take stuff out. That got banned.
Because VidAngel right now, as I understand it from the last time I looked at their video, they are on hold. Like it shut them down. And it's weird too, because the way they work is they actually buy the DVDs from the company, so they're paying for them. They're not pirating. They're not ripping anything off. They buy the DVDs, then they encode them, I guess, and then you do like mm-hmm. like Netflix, and you get the DVD sent to your house, and you can censor. Or yeah. No, I said censor. See, you can filter.
Why are you trying to censor me?
I know exactly.
Well, and Congress passed a law, and I think they said 2007, saying that was explicitly allowed. And so that these studios are now trying to find really bizarre ways to shut that down. It's going against the law.
Yeah, and honestly too, like, how do you look at yourself as a director knowing you've put out a movie and you've got stuff that's questionable in it, and maybe you don't think it is, but you're like, yeah, somebody doesn't want their kid to see that.
Like, how would you feel if someone was taking our podcast and cutting out topics that they didn't want their kids to hear?
If anyone ever does that, I will find you.
There was a station that did that, and you did not like that.
Yeah, that's the thing. If you take the podcast for your personal use and you want to skip past something for your kids because you don't want us to hear, like we have in the show later on today, you'll hear two people talk about being sexually abused. If you want to skip that because your kids aren't ready for that yet, 100% skip that. If you're listening to the radio, change the station. I support that 100%. But when a station takes our product as this is what we're contracted with you to run our show, and then they choose what to run out of it, yeah, I do have a problem with that. Because that's, again, is that public consumption. And what to your point about making it worse, when they take things out and they change the context of what's said, then it's not as good and it's not as it was intended. So I'm on the – I mean, I understand both. But for private consumption, man, you should be able to do whatever you want in your house to – keep it as godly as you choose to make it in your house.
You know what I can't stand? Someone gave us an angry face on Facebook Live.
What?
And I don't know why.
Maybe their finger slipped.
Now, if I put an angry face, does that an angry face to their angry face?
I don't know.
There, I just did it.
You know what? I'm going to give you an angry face on Facebook Live. Like a real angry face, not a lame emoji. There you go, angry face.
There's Grandpa with his understanding of a reaction.
Yeah. If you angry faced us, at least comment. I'm curious why. Like, if we're boring you to death, that's fine. Again, it's free choice. Go somewhere else. But, like, I'm really curious. Like, what is if somebody was offended by something, that would be worth it.
We're talking to you, Paul.
Oh, is it Paul?
Not a Paul we know.
Oh, it's probably Paul Adams.
No, different Paul.
Really? All right, Paul, come on.
Oh, more angry faces coming across.
Really?
Oh, but there's some hearts. Okay.
Okay. Oh, what is wrong with you guys? Seriously? Why do we even do this?
Oh, and Daniel with another. They both cleared out their angry faces.
Anyway. Oh, I am just curious. Like, I didn't think there was anything that deserved an angry face. Is there a face for you're not good at your job? Like, fine, put that one up there. But
there's
like,
a tear, I guess.
Yeah, that's fine. All right. I don't want to get too sensitive about it.
Really?
But this is over.
I need a minute. I'm going to need a second here. Why did we do the Facebook Live? It just hurts, you trolls. You internet troll Paul. That's what's going to happen is people are going to then start using this as a sport to bait me. That always happens. Like, if I read a hate mail, then I'll get, like, five more that start off as a hate mail, and then they're like, just kidding, got you. But by that time, my blood pressure's already shot through the roof, so thank
never,
you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Paul just explained I hit angry face because full screen is right next to
me. See? And like I was saying, Paul is awesome.
Yes.
Like, didn't I not say Paul is a great guy a minute ago?
Paul's the best. I love you, Paul.
Paul rules.
Taking us full screen.
Yeah. We've gone full circle there, too. Thank you, Paul. All right. So that is it for the precast part of this.
I have one more thing.
What?
Just a little lesson on how to use the Wally Show Live to the best of your fullest of your abilities. If you're watching right now on Facebook Live, what you need to do is right here on the screen in this upper right-hand corner, there's a little arrow. Click that arrow. There's a drop down. Make sure you select turn on live notifications, because a lot of people say, I always miss it.
I always miss it, or I always catch the last five minutes.
So make sure you select it.
So easy a Wally could do it.
Live notifications. Yes, that should be the slogan. And then, if maybe you're not the biggest fan of Facebook Live, maybe you're listening to the podcast right now, you can always find us on YouTube. Just go to youtube.com. That's where you find it on the internet.
You can do /c/WallyShow, but that's a little nerdy.
Just search WallyShow.
Oh, yes. Yeah. HTTPS. search WallyShow, and then right below our videos, you can hit the big button that says subscribe. If you need help finding it, the complete list of our precasts is actually online at allwally.com right now. You can go through the playlist.
All right.
Now I'm
going to
have my Vanna White moment.
Nicely done. You killed that. All right.
Would you like to buy a vowel?
All right, let's get on with this thing. Let's do a little bit of iPod roulette.
Ooh. Yeah.
All right, we haven't done this live yet, and so it would help.
Do you want to start a new recording?
I was just going to keep going, but it would help that if we don't mention the Facebook Live during the thing, so because we're going to play this on the show
tomorrow. This is just exclusive for you.
Right.
And then, yeah, it'll be on the show.
You're seeing it a day ahead of time.
Can I run and get my charger so the phone doesn't die so we can stay live then?
Uh-oh.
Do you have a 6?
Yes.
Do you want to use my battery case?
Praise the Lord.
You two nerds are cool.
No, I got it. Hang on. Oh. 5 seconds.
Okay. It's not a 6. Did she lie about having a 6? That's insecure.
No, it's a 6 because she has a headphone jack.
But she couldn't take the headphone jack out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have the 7, so I have to have
my phone.
I have to have a battery.
Oh, that looks so sad. Looks like a little Martian. Way to go, Apple, on that. That was a mistake. I like all the other stuff you do. All right. You guys getting ready?
I'm getting my volume ready.
Okay, yeah, so can we explain, we don't usually do this live because...
This is the first time.
Well, because there's usually, like, the time it takes to move the cord. Mm-hmm. There's just a lot of dead air situations.
Mm-hmm. So it'll be really exciting.
So you'll get to see how it's, you know, this is a special behind-the-scenes kind of thing.
Yes. And just so people know, a lot of people think, oh, I thought your show was always live. It is. This is the only segment that we tape ahead of time is iPod Roulette. And then the calls are taped. We always solicit for things live. But then when the calls come in, we cut them up in here because sometimes people will talk for a long time. So we cut them down for
Because we
got to
watch time. Yeah, exactly. And Reeby's not going to come in here and do iPod Roulette at 6 in the morning.
Right. Yeah.
Well, you've never asked.
I would not blame you. I would never ask you to do that because I know how bad this job stinks sometimes getting up.
And on days when we play back iPod Roulette, we get breakfast.
Yes! Yeah, because it's recording, and so Becca will run the board, and I will head over to McDonald's to see the happy lady that's like, hello! Gosh, I love that lady.
Also, Paul Hood had the angry faces. He was your worship leader back in Georgia. Sorry. Good to throw back to that.
Really?
I wanted to mention that, yeah.
Hey, what's up, Paul? That's awesome. How you doing, brother? That's kind of
cool.
Anyway,
moving on.
That's really funny. That's crazy. Okay, so here we go. This is iPod Roulette, and the way it works is we all have our iPods, and I'm going to reset that. This is how we record things.
Real
we mess
life,
things up.
People.
Yeah, this is how it goes. This is the Wally Show with iPod Roulette, and oh my goodness gracious,
the pressure's on.
I know. This stupid live thing, man. Dadgummit.
You mean the thing you do every day?
Yes, but now I'm thinking about the thing I do every day, and that's messing me up. Ah! All right, so here we go. I gotta get focused here. All right. This is the Wally Show, and we do a little thing called iPod Roulette, where we all set our iPods to random and shuffle, and then we pit them against each other. And Reby from the Blog Report is the judge and jury here.
Yeah.
Welcome, Reby. So who do you want to see matched up first in the round one?
I would like to see Betty and Wally.
Betty and Wally. All right, let's go. Ladies go first.
Oh, okay.
So get your iPod plugged in there, Betty Rock. And again, this is Reby's sole discretion as to which song is the better song to move on into the final round. So here we go. Betty Rock's offering for iPod Roulette.
Come
in. Every girl is dancing.
Something that I actually met Barry Gibb, and he told me he loved me.
No, yes. That's funny because we all go.
Staying alive.
I hate going out on the first round. I really hate going out on the first round.
Get used to it.
Yeah, again, her iPod is bizarre, random, and kind of awesome.
It makes me want to do CPR.
Yeah, that's how you do CPR, is staying alive. All right, so let's see. What is Wally's offering going to be for iPod Roulette that is going to get crushed by the Bee Gees? And...
Do
Oh, such a good song.
Oh, that's not a bad offering. This is Switchfoot.
24 failures and 24 tries.
Here's my problem. Her song was very upbeat, but not a Christian song.
Oh,
and not
dear.
Pointing people to the Lord.
Here we go.
No, I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
This, I love Switchfoot, but this is a.
This is off maybe their best album.
Yes, the Beautiful,
Beautiful Letdown.
Yeah, oh. But this song is.
You're all right. So, sorry that got ugly.
That was a low blow, sir.
I'm sorry.
Not professionally, personally.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's a
okay.
human.
Right.
You're good
okay.
at your job, but yeah, just a bad person. Okay, Reeby, where are you gonna go? I mean, it's either the Bee Gees or
Switchfoot.
Switchfoot
is good, but I have to go with the Bee Gees.
Oh, wow. I never get to win
that
ever.
That song is just. It's just great. It's all catchy. Right.
Well, there
yeah.
you go. Round one goes to Lady Rock, who will now move into the finals, and we'll see who's going to take her on. Will it be Becca or Zach next on The Wally Show? All right. So, hey, Facebook Live, now this is where we reset
oh,
everything
word.
Again.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
It's a separate break.
And then, Betty, you're going to cut all this, remember? Right? Right?
What?
Okay. That's my
All right,
here we go.
Rolling, right?
Yeah, I'm still rolling. Yeah. All right, here we go. This is The Wally Show with iPod Roulette. Round one is in the books. The Bee Gees beat out Switchfoot because of the questionable religious status of Reeby, who does all the judging.
Oh, come on.
Look, I'm worried about your heart.
It has nothing to do with just that I really like the song Staying
yeah.
Alive.
That's okay.
No reason.
All right. You know what would be a great version of that as a Christian song, and that is Staying Alive, like in Jesus. But
well, maybe
that's
what
that's
it reminds
is.
Me of.
Yeah.
Maybe that's
yes.
what it is.
Maybe.
We're staying alive in Jesus.
I doubt
Thank
it.
Thank you,
but,
Barry Gibb.
All right. So here we go. It is Becca taking on Zach in round two.
Which is all I always feel good about this when I go against Zach.
I know. Who doesn't
yeah,
like going
you have
against
a bye
Zach?
In the first
Pretty
round,
much.
Basically.
Okay. Ready?
Yep.
I can see what's happening.
Oh, wow.
Lion King.
Lion King.
Timon and Trio's down to
tail.
That is line.
The rest of twilight. There's magic everywhere. And with all this romantic atmosphere, disasters in the air.
Here it comes. Why is this on your iPod? You don't have a kid.
Why not?
Is this on your self-esteem playlist?
No, but this is one of the first songs I ever bought on iTunes.
Are you serious?
It was one of those moments where I was like, iTunes is so great. There's so many songs. What do I buy? And for some reason, this popped into my head. And so I blew part of a gift card on.
That is bizarre.
Lion King,
such a good
against a different,
solid choice.
Against a different judge, I would think I have a chance. But
right.
not with
but Reeby is a Disney person, too. So
and
that's
it's
tough.
A great song.
It is a good song, but like, I don't see that one. I don't see that one making it through. It's a little too weird.
We'll see.
Yeah.
We'll
so
see.
All right, let's see how Zach right. does with his girl iPod.
Ooh.
Oh.
Ooh.
That's
I have a chance.
A good one, but it's not a classic. Oh.
Mm.
It's hard already.
I put this on for Anna the other day on a music video, and she danced like mad. She loved
Don't
it.
Don't always bring it back
she
to
did
Anna. I bet she loved Lion King even more.
No.
Stop.
All right, so Lion King or...
That's hard.
This is far superior sonically.
Yeah,
musically.
100%.
Let's be honest.
But
this is
Lion
not a
King.
Difficult choice.
Reeby, where were you when you first saw the magic that is Lion
Close
King?
You know, I don't know if I've ever seen it all the way through, to be really honest.
Good point.
It's Can, weird.
Do you know,
but I'm
unless
not that
I was like
old.
Very small, like a very,
this
very
is
small child.
Do you know the guy from this song wanted to get into Christian music? He would go to the Dove Awards and hand out a CD to everybody.
Really?
And,
yeah, we told
and,
yeah. Story
and never
on
got
air.
Called back.
Isn't that fascinating?
And so now he's writing and producing for Beyonce and U2 and everybody in the world, plus his own band, One Republic.
It would have been interesting to see like what his life would have looked like
if he had gotten the break.
If someone
in
had
the genre.
Listened and been like, oh, wow.
I get it. Yeah,
this
yeah,
guy right. has talent.
Now they're going on tour with U2 this year.
Yeah,
are they really?
Wow.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Wow.
All right, okay. Reeby, call it.
Come on.
That was by far Zach's best offer.
Yes,
ever.
It was. Yes.
The iPod roulette.
Yes.
This is
give
the
it to him.
Magic of Disney.
Give it to him.
Between I gotta go with Zach.
Yes! Yes!
Oh, no!
Yes!
I did not see it going that way.
Yeah,
Betty
nicely done.
They were both good, but.
All right, so hey. Zach moving into the finals against Betty Rockford. He will get trounced. So we'll see how that goes here next on The Wally Show.
Wasn't all enough right. for Simba to lose his dad.
Yeah.
Get your iPods ready.
Just rip his heart out.
I hate that I never have to get another song ready. Like I know I don't.
To punch
maybe you should have
random again. I know. Like it's like I never get another chance to play, which is kind of a bummer. Okay.
Mm.
So here we go. We'll start ladies first on this one.
Why?
Oh, what? Because ladies first. That's an advantage.
He's if you got win, his thingamajigger
if you
here.
win Reby's heart early, like okay. So here we go. You ready? This is The Wally Show, and we are down to our final round of iPod Roulette with Betty Rock taking on Zach. Betty Rock got in with the Bee Gees to the finals, and Zach with a Rome Republic song, to the finals with a guy that you might not have known this. We talked about it last time. It's a guy wanted to break into Christian music and couldn't get in and then started writing all these hits for all these other people. So it's kind of a weird story, but, you know, he still has faith and, you know, he's still doing this on this other side, which is kind of cool. But it would have been interesting to see what his career would have looked like here
right.
and what Christian music would have sounded like for a little while, you know, because One Republic is pretty dope. All right, so here we go. Let's start with you, Betty Rock. What is your first song on Shuffle? My goodness, are you kidding me? Wow. Oh my goodness.
That is painful
Led
for
Zeppelin.
You to go up.
Here it goes.
I come from the land of the ice and snow. Yeah. I cannot believe that you have a Led
You're
Zeppelin song on there.
It's great.
I know. I just can't believe that you. I know you have a lot an old iPod, but I never pictured you for having a Led Zeppelin song on your iPod.
Surprising to me.
I'm a classic rock guy too, so I mean, like, I get it, but I'm surprised that was on there.
Good
I
song.
Think I can take it though.
Okay.
All right.
Betty might have met her match.
I don't think you can get lucky twice in a row, Zach.
Usually, Betty's iPod is very eclectic, and it sounds like it could be in a chick flick. That one did not. That was a total departure. All right, Zachary, here we go.
Boy, I feel nervous.
For the finals.
Like I'm on the cusp.
Hit play.
I used to get nervous.
What?
As I look at the mirror.
Oh.
This is Family Force
This
five.
Is my theme song for life.
Family Force 5?
This is
yes.
your theme song?
What is it? And I got no
reason to Dance hide. Like nobody's watching.
Ah. My legs started shaking.
Man, there ain't no bacon. All right.
This
move that I'm
making with This is Family
People
Force 5. Oh, yeah.
We are watching Wally, so don't dance
oh,
like nobody's
word.
Watching.
I'm gonna dance like nobody's watching. Nobody's watching, so I'll dance like I don't even care. I'm gonna move like it's not an option. Okay, Zach,
I like this.
He can't win this round unless he actually dances like nobody's watching.
Yeah. No.
You all have
true.
To turn around then.
Dance, yes.
Dance,
and
dance. So no. all of Facebook Live can
you,
see you. It's
no.
like nobody's watching that.
Oh, but they are. I don't want to win that bad. My oh. dignity is important. Congratulations, Betty Rock.
What's your dignity, man?
No,
come on.
I'm voting for
what?
You, Zach.
I know.
Oh, wow.
Come on.
Family Force 5.
Dance.
No, not so much.
Look, you
I
can
only
be doing
dance
this.
With my daughter.
Really? Like, yeah, okay.
That's a letdown, Zach.
Yeah, I know. I know, life is full of disappointments.
All right, and you're
I need
one
to
of
let
them.
The music speak for itself.
Yeah, all right, Reby, where are you going?
The wider appeal, I think, which I'm going with,
yeah.
is Betty Rock.
What?
Wider
that
appeal?
That was personal.
You, like, picked my hopes up
yes.
and then slammed yes. it down.
Dance. If you had danced.
All right.
I really, I'll be honest with you, did not see that going that way. Congratulations,
Woo!
Betty Rock, winning her 27th victory in iPod Roulette.
She came into this, she's like, I'm nervous today. I don't know.
Yeah,
like,
yeah you should have, honestly, Zach, you should have won that one. I'm sorry.
Oh, thank
hey,
you.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
I'll take my victory.
Sorry.
And, like, everybody knows who Led Zeppelin is, not necessarily Family
I know,
Force
5. I know.
And
but,
Zach
So
dance.
This is a popularity contest, not a contest of,
mm-hmm.
of music.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. All right, whatever. All right. You've made a mockery of it.
Yeah.
All right, we'll do a losers. We'll do a loser's bracket here next on The Wally Show.
I wanted to give you that note because I
yeah.
didn't want to interrupt.
So we get a full hour of breakfast tomorrow.
Yes.
I don't care either way, but. I do.
Loser bracket with three or two? We've done it both ways.
Because it's the worst song is what we do.
Yeah. Yeah, we can go three. All right, you ready?
Okay.
You just got to go fast. Yeah. I'm a huge Led Zeppelin fan from back in the day, but I can't remember that song. And there's so many things that they have questionable stuff in their songs, you know, and that's one that I couldn't remember. And I'm like, that's why I pulled it down on you.
Yeah,
mark.
I figured, but yeah. It doesn't.
Yeah. I could not remember, and I didn't want to take that chance.
Do you want me to go out first?
Yeah, you already got the thing. Yeah, sure.
But this is the worst song. So.
Yeah, so, right. Okay. I am a contender then.
Oh,
yes.
My gosh.
This is iPod Roulette. Betty Rock winning today on the round. But now we have the loser's bracket. We're looking for the worst song here. And Reby, you can be the judge of that as always. So, Zach, we're going to start with you. What do you got here? What's your offering?
Let's see what we got. Oh, I like these guys.
What is that?
This is a good song.
Doesn't sound good.
Oh, this is good.
This is so good. This is one of my more favorite Christian albums in the world. It's Icon for Hire, but it sounds exactly like Paramore.
Paramore, yeah.
But I feel like this album is better than the last Paramore album.
Oh, yeah, the Paramore fell off, man.
When their guitarist left?
Yeah.
Like the two guys?
The two guys. I'll give you that. That's good. That's good. All right. That's a good offering.
But we're not looking for Icon good.
For Hire.
We're looking
so
for
good.
Bad.
Icon for Hire.
Icon for Hire. Check them out.
They remind me of Firefly.
Yeah.
Firefly.
Flyleaf.
Yeah.
Oh, and Firefly.
Well, no, Firefly.
Yes,
with Dawn.
No.
Fireleaf.
Flyleaf.
Flyleaf.
No. Definitely. I think they're definitely more Paramore and Firefight. Firefly. With Dawn.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they're great.
Betty, not Betty Rock. Betty, Becca, you over there. All right. Tall girl.
I know this, and I cannot believe you have this.
I can't believe
you
I didn't think I had this.
This is so bad.
I might have to fast forward. I can't remember how it starts.
You need the chorus. I know when
cause I want it all or nothing at all.
No, who is it though?
O-Town.
That's it. You have O-Town on your phone. You might win this. Yeah. I used to have to play this stuff.
It's so
when
bad.
I was at Radio Disney, I had to play and interview O-Town. Like and act like I gave
That's
a rip.
Terrible.
Oh, it's horrible. Okay, to me.
And they were local for you then, right? Was that when you were in Orlando?
Is that what it stands for?
I think so.
Yeah, when I was in
Orlando.
Orlando
Town.
And that is the last of my O-Town trivia. That
and that was it? I'm out. All right, here we go. This is my offer. I think Becca's going to win this thing.
Nice.
Oh! You mentioned him earlier.
It's Firefly. Right?
It's Firefly.
Oh. There you go.
What are the odds of that?
I think mine stands out a little bit today.
It does stand out.
This is a great song.
In a bad way. Yep.
Christian band Firefly. I miss them. They were so nice. They're responsible. Favorite moments on the show, Fee the drummer. I was making fun of him like all night long, and I'm like, he said something else. He goes like, I got a story, but it's probably not worth telling. I'm like, yeah, it probably isn't. And I'm like, oh, let's see. And so I'm like, Fee, I am sorry. I've been picking on you all night. And Fee's
you can
like,
play it if you want.
Oh, do you have
I
it?
Do.
Wow, we have that on replay there. That's kind of cool. There you go. Yeah, this was me.
He's no longer
drumming
with him.
He's like a speaker. He turned into like a motivational like Christian speaker. So.
Probably from the hurt that you inflicted upon him.
But I made him better. Like he could have just been a drummer in a band that like works here
just
and there
been
now.
A drummer.
You kidding me? I made this guy better. You're welcome, Fee. We're talking to the guys slash ladies from the band Fireflight, and you guys are from Orlando, so do you remember that boy band O-Town?
Oh, I have a funny story about that, but we probably don't have time to tell it.
And I doubt it's funny, Pete.
it's really funny.
Pete, again, I'm sorry, Pete. I've been picking on Pete all night, so I apologize. Once again, I am so sorry. That was not cool.
Your apology doesn't count if you keep doing it.
O-Town!
That is the biggest full circle.
What is happening?
Weird iPod roulette ever. Like, all of these bands we're talking about in O-Town, then we're talking about O-Town 6 years ago?
Man.
Insane. That's all right.
Too bad you didn't let him tell the story.
I know, it wouldn't have been good. All right, so... all right, Rebe, call it. Who wins the loser's bracket?
Oh, Becca.
Yes! With her O-Town offering.
So good.
Perfect. All right. Well, there you go. That is really bizarre.
That is crazy. That was so funny.
That's funny. All right. Well, there you go. So that's all done. And so now, Facebook Live, thank you very much for indulging us. Did people keep watching through some of that, Zach?
Yeah. They didn't seem to like the loser round as much as the previous rounds.
What?
Which is interesting.
Well, how do
it's
we know?
The same thing. Well,
did they say they don't
number
like
of viewers, number of comments,
went down
and likes.
A little bit.
Maybe once someone wins, it's like, oh, that's game over.
Maybe.
So, I don't know. Anyway, that's
people
good.
Have lives.
Yeah.
So you hit
thank you.
Yes, bye.
Facebook.
Bye.